The chief guest of today's event needs no special introduction at all. Be it a COVID crisis or a cultural event, she leaves no stone unturned to be there for her citizens. She believes in India before anything else. She is a strong supporter and encourager for ISRK. Dear all, please join me in welcoming the chief guest of today's event, Indian Ambassador to Republic of Korea, Ms. Sri Priya Ranganathan. Ma'am, we know how busy you are, and we are extremely grateful to you that you could take out your time and spend an evening with us. The space is all yours.
Thank you so much, Apurva, for an exceedingly generous introduction. I think this is, I feel a little intimidated by the kind of people who are there in the room today, and I think you have been extraordinarily kind. But let me begin by first recognizing the presence of Padma Bhushan Professor Ganguly, former DG of the ICMR. I think Dr. Jerome Kim is supposed to be there, my good friend, the DG of the International Vaccine Institute, though I don't see him on screen at the moment. Professor Harish Pad, who I have never had the privilege of meeting, but I have heard about you. And of course, Dr. Lailesh Kumar, who is the president of the Indian students and researchers of Korea, who is really the brain behind this this event that we are all part of today, and of course all our friends from India and from Korea alike. It is truly a great pleasure to be part of this very unusual event that we have, a series of events that has been launched by the ISRK to recognize and applaud the contributions of distinguished Indian scientists across the ages. I think it is particularly timely that this event should come just as we begin our celebrations of India at 75. As all the Indians in the audience will know, we began our journey as a nation just under 75 years ago, and we are looking forward to our 75th birthday, if you will, on the 15th of August, 2022. And what we have tried to do at the embassy, and I think this is kind of all of government enterprise and all across the world, Indian missions are doing this. We are trying to mark this this milestone with some sort of activity, some sort of events that highlight some element of what we have achieved in these 75 years. And we started this process 75 weeks before the 15th of August, 2022. So we began on the 15th of March. So I think this initiative has come at a brilliant time in terms of what we are trying to celebrate and what we are trying to applaud. Again, it bears no repeating that the kind of rigor and the kind of depth of scientific inquiry in India has been very, very long lasting, and we all take pride in the fact that the zero was discovered or invented, if you will, in India, that the wheel was invented in India. We have the great works of Sushruta and Aryabhatta and Patanjali to guide us in terms of our what we have inherited from our ancestors. And in modern India too, we have made some significant strides in scientific exploration and discovery. And I think we would not be here today as a nation that we are if over these 75 years our leaders had not given the kind of importance to science and scientific education as they did. And what we have today as witness to that is the fine institutions that have been created, the Indian Institutes of Technology, the Indian Institute of Science, which is one of the most iconic educational institutions in science in the country and abroad, I would say. More recently, the Indian Institutes of Information Technology, the kind of fantastic research institutions that have been created, whether it is ISRO, whether it is CSIR, whether it is the organizations that work with the Department of Biotechnology. I think all of these institutions have really served us very well over these past several decades. And we have to our credit, scientists like in all possible fields, whether it is Swaminathan, Dr. Swaminathan in the field of who gave us the Green Revolution, whether it is Dr. Kurian who gave us the White Revolution, Dr. Abdul Kalam, who of course was the was not only a great scientist but also our very, very beloved president. I mean, we can just go on and on and on, and I guess that is the entire purpose of the series which the ISRK has launched, that not only should those of us who are in India know and appreciate these greats who have gone before us, but that the more current generation in India and abroad should remember them and recognize them for what they are. I should also say, since I am the Indian ambassador in Korea, I have to talk about the India-Korea Connect. I think it is what we have is a great asset, in that the researchers community, the Indian researchers community here is so strong. It was a discovery for me when I came here that we have about 8,000 strong student community, of which there is a large chunk which is in the field of the various kinds of sciences. It has been made a very, very, very small effort at the embassy to try and connect with as many of them as possible. This has not been very successful in the past year or so because of the COVID restrictions, which has meant that we have not been able to meet in person. But certainly the thought process is very much there, and we did have the opportunity last year or early this year when Prime Minister had an interaction with Indian origin scientists around the world, to be able to have two of our scientists right here in Korea join him at that table. And we are very proud that we were able to highlight the India-Korea connection in that manner. I also hope that, not as part of this event, but as a larger India-Korea connection, that we are able to build on some of these very strong foundation that has been created, and that Indian scientists and researchers who are working here in Korea will go back to India, will be able to contribute, will be able to take the learnings from Korea into the organizations that they work for in India, and vice versa, that there are people in India who are currently working at such organizations who come to Korea, who are able to share some of what they have learned, what they have researched, what they have discovered. There is, I find, a great deal of respect in Korea for Indian, the scientific temper and the kind of commitment and the sheer intelligence of our people. So this is something which makes me very proud. So that is really all that I have to say from my side. But I thank you so much for inviting me and for allowing me to share my thoughts. And I look forward greatly to not only this to our discussions today, but all those to follow. Thank you so much.